YouTube has a lot of videos about our lost ancient high technology, but the who and the how often go unanswered. So I have decided to do this video on how the polygonal stones were quarried and then transported to their installation locations. My previous video was somewhat easy to do. How to build a polygonal megalithic wall using sonic tech. It just kind of makes sense. The bottom stones were softened, then the stone on top was sonicked into place on top of it. The stone had to be steered into place using insulated soft sticks. Practice and experience then made it possible to build the fantastic polygonal megalithic walls that are all around Cusco, with the largest in Sacsayhuaman. But regarding the quarrying and the transport of these stones, I'm finding that polygonal megalithic Peru might be the most difficult place to start. I should have chosen the Aswan Quarry, or maybe the quarry at Lebanon and the Trilithon stones. But no, I decided on Peruvian quarries, polygonal, crazy stuff. Well, here goes. Sacsayhuaman itself is an engineering enigma, and across from it is an even crazier pile of mysteries. The hill itself is called the Rodadero and is a volcanic push. The Rodadero appears to have oozed up and out of the ground. It looks like awesome quality granite. So, why wasn't the Rodadero quarried? It's great stuff. They must have been saving the best granite to be used last. I don't know. Next to it, though, instead of a quarry, you find weird piles of stuff that look more like tortured, reconstituted slag, like they were reforming and reusing their leftovers. It's a distorted, messed up landscape. And scattered all around, you will find hundreds of cut seats and shelves and steps, like it was a training ground for what the heck is that? I don't know. It's bizarre. I was hoping to find a hole in the ground with telltale cut marks so that I could illustrate this how-to video. Nope. There's a field of nicely cut stones, and they could be megalithic, but they could be Inca or Spanish too. As for quarry marks, there are surprisingly few examples of a rotary blade or a saw or even the scoops. What isn't here are plunging holes like in Egypt, perfect corners and edges, like in Egypt and at Pumapunku, and perfect scrapings, like at Petra. And to add to the mystery, around Sacsayhuaman, there are examples of an ancient freehand cutting tool that we haven't seen anywhere else. It is believed that the quarry from which these megaliths came from is 3 kilometers away. Brian Forster put together an excellent video of it. He didn't seem completely convinced, though. I don't believe that the largest stones here at Sacsayhuaman came from 3 kilometers away. I think the largest stones are quite local, and that what's left of the limestone quarry for this fantastic ancient location was filled in. Regardless, these huge stones had to be cut and then moved. So it's time for me to get to the topic of this video. How the stones were quarried and then transported. Sonic tech is the central tech in lost ancient high technology. And here at Sacsayhuaman, the typical radial blade and thousands of hammers and shaping stones were assisted by a large sonic saw for the large cuts, dozens of the sonic swords for the smaller cuts, and of course, the sonic scoops for basic shaping. For transporting the rocks, a sonic debonding plate is used to isolate the gravitational pull of the stones from the earth. I realize that sonic vibration and sonic molecular realigning is hard to believe, but some kind of lost technology did this. This is real rock. It's not some kind of cement. And I have a harder time believing in lightsabers. Please also enjoy the YouTube works of Brian Forster, Ancient Architects, and Jimmy of Bright Insight, and many others. Thank you for watching. Please like and share.